I think we can do it.
Hey everyone, I'm Shirin.
And I'm Myles.
The host of Above the Noise, the show that cuts through the hype
and digs into the facts behind the headlines.
So today we're going to be talking about energy drinks. And just to recap the last episode, in 2011, a paper published in the journal Pediatrics reviewed the effects of energy drinks on children, adolescents, and young adults. The paper looked at 121 reports, two-thirds of which were published in academic journals. And in all of this research, there are still two big unknowns. One, does your age affect how your body responds to caffeine? And two, how do all these additives and caffeine interact with each other? Clearly, there's still a lot they're figuring out, but in the meantime, the experts warn that energy drinks could be especially risky for kids with heart problems, ADHD, or diabetes.
So, let's jump right into the comments. We have a question from Raquel, who says, don't energy drinks contain a lot of chemicals? It's not just sugar and caffeine. What makes them special? And what about the rest of the ingredients?
So, actually, those other things in energy drinks, the hype, those are the elements that are the most unstudied as compared to something like, say, caffeine. So there's ingredients like taurine and guarana, which both have exotic names and are pretty unknown in terms of how they interact with each other and with caffeine.
So basically, in doing your research and, you know, looking into all the stuff that you did for this video, was there anything that you came across that was crazy? Because I was doing some stuff and I found, you know, cases of people dying and people claiming that the energy drinks were like the reason these people were dying. So.
Yeah, it's kind of nuts, and that's something that I've always heard about, that people die because of energy drinks, and it turns out there's nothing that we can say 100% proven this person died because of an energy drink, but a lot of families have sued energy drink companies, saying that they think that's the main reason, that their loved one was otherwise healthy. Like, for example, in 2011, a man in Brooklyn died after downing Red Bull and playing basketball, and his family sued for $85 million. I believe that case is still in litigation. There's another case in 2012 where a 14-year-old girl from Maryland died after having two monster drinks within a 24-hour period.
That's terrible.
Yeah. So it's hard to say definitively, but there's definitely some families that believe that. And because of this, the FDA has opened kind of an investigation into it, and they're starting to list all the reported cases.
And last up, we have Divya, who says, has banning energy drinks in the countries mentioned, Lithuania, been effective?
So I scoured the internet for research about Lithuania and the effects of this ban. Not a lot out there. However, in Berkeley, California, they implemented a soda tax. And that's been studied in terms of the effects. And what they found was that in a study published by UC Berkeley and UCSF researchers, there was a 21% drop in the drinking of soda and other sugary beverages amongst Berkeley's low-income neighborhoods after the city put this tax in place.
Oh, dope.
Yeah.
We need more soda tax. No, I'm just kidding. So, I mean, how do you feel about energy drinks? Like, do you drink them at all?
Honestly, no. I have coffee. Like, I need coffee to survive, but not energy drinks as much.
No, I can't even drink coffee. I remember, like, the last time I drank coffee, I had one cup. I was really young. I was, like, 10. And then out of nowhere, I was out of town with my grandmother visiting, and I remember my mother called me, which was like, hey, just telling you I miss you, and, you know, hopefully I'll see you in a couple weeks, yada, yada, yada. I was like, all right, for sure. And then after the phone call, I finished a cup of coffee, and I just started bawling. I'd been gone for a minute, so it wasn't like I like missed her hella, but you know, I just was like overwhelmed with emotion and energy, and I blame the coffee from that day. So I haven't had a cup of coffee since I was like 9 or 10 years old. So that's how I feel about caffeine in general, kinda.
That's amazing. Yeah. You might be the only journalist I know who does not drink coffee.
I can't do it.
That's cool.
Black tea is the way to go. Shameless plug. But I mean, let us know what you guys think. I mean, how do you feel? Like, what do you feel about energy drinks? What do you think could be done? Let us know in the comments below. We'll do our best to look through them. And remember, we're the host of Above the Noise, the show that cuts through the hype
and takes you above the noise.